Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. This is my website studysalesforce.com. So here you can find links of all the videos together created by me on Salesforce. So in this video, we are going to discuss about before delete and after delete operations. Those are available in Apex Trigger. So first scenario is for before delete. So employee record cannot be deleted if active is true. So on employee, I have created employee object. I have created active field, custom field, that is Boolean field. If it is true, then employee record cannot be deleted and this operation will be done in before trigger. So whenever delete is performed on employee, so this should be performed. So let me first implement this one. So here you can see on employee custom object, I have created employee trigger, which will run in delete context in before. And this method will be executed, check employee status. So right now I am commenting this one because this is for after after operation, or you can say after delete. So in case of before and after delete, we need to pass trigger.old variable. So new is not available because whenever we delete any record, so it automatically will be available in trigger.old. So you can see in both the cases, we are passing trigger.old. And in the handler, I'm going to fetch this into old list. So parameter will be received here. And whenever you are going to implement trigger, so this is the best practice in trigger, you just need to call the methods. Those will be available in the trigger handler classes. And then in the class, you can implement the actual logic. So now old list is iterated. One by one, employee record will be available in EMP. And if active is true, then this error message will be displayed. So now if I move here, go to employee record. So here you can see this active checkbox is true. So now if I try to delete this, so an error message will be available. Active employee cannot be removed. And if I uncheck this, save this. Now, if I try to delete, so this record will be deleted. Right. So this way you can perform some operations by performing delete operation in with the help of before delete. Now, next is after delete. So for this, we have scenario. So when employee record is deleted, then update left employee count on account. So you need to assume that our employee records are looking up to account. So they share lookup relationship. So account is on parent side and employee is on child side. Whenever any employee record is deleted, so we need to count like how many records are till now deleted from a particular account. So that will be available in left employee count variable. So now if we move to the trigger, so here you can see in same trigger handler class, we have one more method that is update left employee count on account. And again, we are passing trigger.old. So here, if you see this method is available, it is receiving old list. And these are some variables that we are going to use. So first, what we are going to do, we are going to filter the old list, so that we can identify those employee records which are looking up to account only. So if on employee account field is not equals to null, then account IDs will be available into the set that is created here. And employee record will be added to this list, EMP list that is created here. So after filtering, if this ID set is not empty, then we need to query accounts. Those will be having ID and left employee count value, and where ID in this account IDs. So the account IDs that we are filtering, those account we are querying, and they will be available into this map. Now, if list is not empty, it means we have certain employee records. Those are deleted and they are looking up to account as well. So we are iterating that list. Now, if we now we are checking this map that we queried, which is having accounts. So if the deleted employee records account ID is available in this map, then we are performing this operation. So this is a bit tricky. Like you need to understand it. if we are deleting only one employee record, that is looking up to account, so then we can perform simple operation like we can add the existing left employee count value by one, right? But if we are deleting five employee records in bulk and those five employee records are looking up to same account, so in that case, in the code, we need to identify like five employee records are deleted and we need to increment this plus one by five times, right? So what we are doing, we are maintaining a map account ID to total count. So at top, you can see this map is of type, its key is ID and value is of type decimal. So first we are checking whether it is having any account ID or not. So initially it will be blank. So contains key will be false. So this else part will be executed. So we are putting account ID as key, that is on employee record. And through this map, we are fetching the current left employee count value that is available on the account. And for this first deleted employee, we are incrementing it by one. And we are storing it in the local map, right? Let's say next employee record will be available from this list. That is also looking up to same account and that is available in this map. Then again, we are checking this local count map, whether that employee account key is available or not. So this time it will be true because second time the employee record which we are deleting, it is looking up to same account that was looking up by the previous employee record that we traversed. So we are fetching the count value. So now this map is having the count value and we are fetching it through get, incrementing it by one, storing into count, and then again we are updating the map. So we are putting that account ID and the updated count value, right? So this way, if same employee records will be available, those are looking to same account. So this map will be maintaining the values. So key will be account ID and the current left count value will be available in this count and will be available in this map. So after completion of this process, we need to iterate the map, the count map. So through key set, we will be iterating and account ID will be stored in this ACC and the left count will be get through map and stored here, right? So updated count will be available and then this list will be updated. So this is the list ACC account to be updated list. So if it is not null, then account records will be updated. So this way, whenever an employee record is deleted, or in bulk, you are going to delete some employee records. So the related accounts will be updated on this field, left employee count. So now I'm going to take two account records and we are going to delete the related employee records, right? And then we will see what will happen on the account object with this left employee count field. So I hope you understood this code. So maybe you can implement this code in your org. So one by one, you can type each and every line, and then you can understand like line by line what is happening in this code. So I'm scrolling it slowly so that you can, by pausing this video, you can write the code in your org. Now I am moving to the org and let me pick this account ACC EMP. And if we go to details, so here we need to check the value of that field. So here you can see it is already having four as left employee count. So it means I already deleted four records related to this as employee. And right now it is not having any related employee. So now I'm going to create two related employee for this. So this is the ID and designation, let's say dev one, clicking on save. So one employee record is created, then creating one more. Dev two, right? So two employee records are created for this account. Now, so its name is ACCEMP, right? Now I'm going to create one more account record. And I am naming it as ACCEMP1, right? And I am clicking on save. So record is created. Now I'm moving to details. So here you can see by default its value is zero because whenever I created this field, so I made a default value as zero. Otherwise we need to also check this in the code, like if it is not zero or null, then we need to initialize it first and then we can add the values. Otherwise null pointer exception will be thrown. So I'm creating first employee. So it is dev3. And now I'm going to create one more employee. So it is dev4. So now we have two accounts, ACCEMP and ACCEMP1. So on ACCEMP, left count is already 4, and on ACCEMP1, left count is 0, right? Now I'm moving to developer console, opening anonymous window. And now here I'm going to query employee records. And then in bulk, I will be deleting them. So let me first save it. So I'm saving the trigger so that it will run properly. Now list of employee, EMP list equals to select ID from employee where account __ C equals to ACCEMP. So this is first condition, or ACCEMP1, right? So let me just check it with debug, system.debug, EMP list, right? So I'm just executing this, opening the debug log. Okay, there's an error. Yep, so it executed. I forgot to mention colon sign. So now it will show the result in debug. Okay, debug is blank. So there is some mistake. Okay. So I'm just matching it with name, but I need to match it with ID, right? So this is incorrect. So I'm picking the ID because IDs will be available there. So this or the another one. So that is ACCEMP. So for demo purpose, I am picking this ID because in real time, we don't use these IDs. So why I am doing so? So that I can show you how we can perform bulk deletion. Otherwise, we would have deleted those employees one by one from the UI. So in that case, you won't be seeing the case like if we are deleting bulk records, so how that trigger will be working. So again, I'm going to execute this. So this time it will fetch the records. Yeah, here you can see. So two records are available here and total four records are available, right? So result is correct because we have four. So for this account, we have two employee records related, and for this account also we have two employees related. So now what I'm going to do, I'm going to perform delete operation on this EMP list, right? So Total four records will be deleted in bulk. So I'm executing this. Okay, so delete operation performed. So now I'm refreshing it. So from UI, we will be checking the left employee count field. What will be the value of this? So in case of this ACC EMP, earlier it was 4. So now it should be 6. So here you can see it is 6. And if we move to related, so here you can see no employee record is associated. And if I open ACC EMP 1, so you will see employee are not related, and in details you can see left employee count is 2. So this way, after performing bulk deletion, this code is working fine. So this way, I hope by practicing you will understand this logic as well. So initial value will be available from here. So it will be executing one time only. Whenever first employee record will be available, that is looking up to one account, and the another employee record will be available, that is looking to same account. In that case, this if condition will be true, and accordingly results will be calculated, right? So this way, I hope you understood both before delete and after delete operations. So I also demonstrated you like how we can perform bulk deletion operations. So this you can perform as well for insertion and updation as well. So from anonymous window, you can try that, or from UILs also. So this is my website, studysalesforce.com. So here all the links related to Salesforce videos created by me are available. So you can visit that and learn Salesforce. Thank you for watching this video.